second? Not yet. Steel xylophone, known to one or two more tortured musicians as Llewellyn's hanging planks. Here we have a little instrument that I think, well, it's pretty well legendary by now, because as soon as you pick up one of these, most people think of one of the greatest of all the music hall stars. So here we go. You want to clap your feet, you want to tap your hands. Come along, join in for a couple of minutes. Very small tribute, but very one and only. George. That's the fellow.
Oh.
yeah, we're going to show the money. We're going to get the big one out. What do you expect? Anybody recognise money?
Yes.
What? Penny whistle, very good. Any other offers besides penny whistle? Penny whistle we've got? Don't doubt. How about tin whistle? That one? Good, that's wrong as well. No, I'm hoping you're right. Honestly, for about 200 years, you were dead right. This little instrument was known generally as the penny whistle. Sometimes the tin whistle, for obvious reasons, but usually the penny whistle. About 200 years, till about 10, 12 years ago, something came into being called the Trades Descriptions Act. Have you heard about it?
Yeah.
This is true. Nowadays, at £1.28 each, there is no way they'll let you advertise these as penny whistles. It's true. You've got to use the posh name, right? Mm. Do you want to hear it?
Yeah.
Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
The flageolet. Yeah. The flageolet. You're sporting now. It's a good name. Yeah, it doesn't make the whistle sound any better, but the name's good. Right, hands up the Scots. Come on, hands up. Wave them around because it's bright. Can't see them. Where are the Scots, eh? Got one or two, have we?
Right now.
No Scots?
No Scots.
Oh, the Scots, come on, the Scots get everywhere. You've always got to come prove it with a name like mine. How are you?
He's a funny Scots.
Hello, Williams.
He's a funny Scots.
One Welsh dad, two Scots grandmothers. You work that one out. They're everywhere. Right, we're going to have a lot of Erzak Scots for about the next minute. That means make-believe, right? If you've got a good old screech, a Gaelic hoot or a yell, and you want to get rid of it, now is your opportunity, right? You'll never get a better, it's better than a dose of Finnans. Let it out. This is real. If you're not up to that, you can come in with the rhythm section. It's not too hard. What you do is, you put your hands together just like this. You go, a one, better, up, four. Have you gone?
But I don't go for anyone of these.
I'd like to close up, not too loud, not too fast. Something slow, something sweet, something melodious, and perfectly in keeping with the afternoon. So we're going to have a hymn, all right? Well, you're safe with hymns. Most people know the tunes, a few know the words. You've got about 240-odd years to learn the words of this one. If you don't know them by now, give up. But I tell you what, there's no problem here, because you can be very useful in the way of accompaniment. Now, can you hum? Yeah. You can talk to me, don't charge. Can you hum?
Yes!
Wonderful. If you hum nice and loudly, I can promise you a musical experience. With a little bit of luck and a following wind, you could sound just like Highland bagpipes.